We're not going to sugarcoat anything anymore. We've been quiet long enough.
In 1996, R&B group TLC stunned a room full of reporters at the Grammy Awards. They were still holding the two Grammys they'd won for Best R&B Album and Best R&B Performance by a Group when they told the press this.
We are the biggest selling female group ever. 10 million albums worldwide. We have worked very hard. We have been in this business for 5 years.
5 years.
And we are broke as broke can be. And we're not like trying to be a sad story. If that was the case, we would have been on everybody's talk show talking about how broke we are. We haven't done that. I know it's hard to believe because we've sold so many albums, but it is possible. That's the deal here. So, and we're not happy at all.
Unable to believe such a successful group could still be broke, a reporter asked them how this was possible.
Well, first of all, 10 million albums, and how can we be broke? I can't go into everything right now, but trust me, you can sell 10 million albums and be broke if you have greedy people behind you.
Now, first, that answer may seem cryptic, almost evasive, but the long pause before answering suggests there's more to this. Just what was it she couldn't get into? Maybe it was the fact that 6 months before the Grammy Awards, all three members of the group had filed for bankruptcy. That's right, in July 1995, with their biggest hit, Waterfalls, still at number one, the group all filed for bankruptcy, reportedly owing over $3 million between them. Lisa Lopez did later go into detail about the reason the group weren't profiting from the sales of the album.
All right, this is how a group can sell 10 million records and be broke. And everyone, get ready to do your math. Okay, there are 100 points on the album. TLC had 7. Every point is equal to 8 cents. 7 times 8, 56 cents. That means every time an album gets sold, TLC gets 56 cents. So 10 million records, $5.6 million. Seems like a lot of money. Well, it's not a lot of money when the record company has spent $3 million to record your album. And in the record business, we pay all costs back to the record company. We pay recording costs, video costs. So now we have $2.6 million left. Well, guess what? When you have that much money, you're in about the 47, 48, 49% tax bracket. So that immediately gets deducted to $1.3 million. Then you split the rest three ways. You got about $300,000 apiece, if that much.
Okay, so let's get into some of those numbers. In this case, points is just another way of saying percent. TLC's deal with the record label granted them a 7% royalty. These types of deals were based on gross profit. That's the amount the label sold the copies for, minus the manufacturing cost per unit. The retail cost of a CD in the 90s was typically around $15 when sold at full price. The stores would have around about a 35 to 45% markup, so they would be buying them at around about $8.50. For most large record labels, pressing a CD costs around 15 cents per disc, with another 35 cents or so for the packaging. So the gross profit on each disc was $8. So each percentage point is worth 8 cents. TLC's 7% is therefore worth 56 cents. All expenses are deducted from the artist's share. This includes studio costs, which even in a modest studio of the time would easily have been at least $1,000 a day. The album was in production for nearly a year, so studio costs of $200,000 or more would not have been hard to rack up. There were also more than 40 other musicians, singers and producers who contributed to the project. They'd also need to be paid. Then there's the music videos. In the 90s, the average video budget for an R&B act like TLC was at least $250,000. But they didn't always make average videos. The video for Waterfalls cost over $1 million. And although nowhere near as expensive, the video for Creep also dented their profits, as they scrapped the first video they filmed and shot a second one. In that video, each of the outfits they wore were custom-made at a cost of over $1,000 each. Pretty much every time the record label had to foot the bill for something, it would be deducted from the artist's share of royalties. So it's easy to see where the $3 million went. For some less experienced artists, it's not always clear that at the end of the day they'll pay for everything themselves. The other thing to consider is the time span. The royalties an artist receives is meant as a payment for the entire process of writing, recording, and promoting an album. They may get paid for some of the gigs, but recording sessions, interviews, and other public appearances would have been unpaid promotional work. Artists can spend weeks, months, even years promoting an album. TLC went into the studio and started working on the album towards the end of 1993. It was completed in September of 1994 and released in November. The album, titled Crazy Sexy Cool, sold 77,500 copies in the first week alone. It was certified double platinum, that's 2 million sales, in January of 1995. Now, most major labels distribute royalties twice a year, around June and then again around December time. The royalties paid in June would cover the sales up to the end of the previous year. So in June 1995, there would have been around 2 million sales to account for. At 56 cents a copy, that would be $1.2 million. With $3 million in cost to recoup, they would be at minus $1.8 million. So there'd be no royalties paid in this statement. They'd need to sell another 3.2 million copies, 5.2 million in total, just to get to zero. In July 1995, the album did reach 5 million sales. At the time of the Grammys in February of 1996, the album had 9 million certified sales. The previous royalty payment should have been due around December of 1995, but would probably have only covered the period up to around June, so they wouldn't quite have reached zero yet. So as they stood there holding their awards around 2.5 years after they started working on the album, it's likely they'd received absolutely nothing from the sales. The royalty payment around June 1996 would have been the first time they received any money. As Lisa Lopez stated, it was around $300,000 for each member after tax. But then there's the manager's fees. The usual fee paid to a manager is around 10 to 15% of earnings, maybe even as much as 20% in some cases. The group's manager, Pebbles, is alleged to have taken an unfair share, much higher than usual, possibly up to 50%. It's an allegation she denies. It's been reported that once everything had been recouped and everybody had received their fees and tax had been paid, each member of the group received about $50,000 for each of the 3 years they worked on recording and promoting the album. To give that a bit of context, the median wage in the USA in the mid-90s was around $25,000, with the average working week being around 40 hours. For an internationally known pop act, the hours would be much longer. Video shoots often start at 5 a.m. and can last 16 hours a day. There's hundreds, maybe thousands of interviews and appearances. It's likely they were working the equivalent of 80 hours or more a week. And let's not forget something else. If TLC were earning just 7%, then the labels involved were earning the other 93%. Instead of 56 cents a copy, they're getting $7.44. 10 million record sales is over $74 million. So how did they end up with such a bad record deal? Well, they initially signed a production and management deal with Pebbles. A singer who'd had hits in the late 80s and early 90s, who'd now set up a management and production company. She owned the band's name and financed their first recordings. She eventually got the group signed to LaFace Records, the label owned by singer-songwriter and producer Babyface, and co-owned by L.A. Reid, who was married to Pebbles. She negotiated the terms of the deal, and the only legal advice the then 19-year-old members of TLC had was from lawyers arranged by Pebbles. Founding member of the group, Crystal Jones, the original C in TLC, was so confused by the lengthy contract, she asked to take it home for her mother to read before signing it. Pebbles refused, so Crystal walked away from the group she had started.
It was based on the contract. When we got to, I won't say his name, but when we got to the lawyer's office, it was myself, Tiana, and Lisa sitting there. And keep in mind, we're 18, 19-year-olds, okay? So we're sitting there, and I'm going through the paperwork, you know, and it's lengthy, and I didn't understand anything. So I turned and I looked to Pebbles and I said, you know, can I take it home? Let my mom take a look at it because I really don't understand what I'm reading. And she said, no, absolutely not. So I didn't sign it.
The imbalance in the distribution of profits isn't unusual and can happen to even the biggest bands. In their original contract with EMI, the Beatles earned just one penny for each record sold. Singles sold for 6 shillings and 3 pence in those days. A shilling was 12 pence, so they were just getting 1/75th of the retail price. That's about 3% of the wholesale price. So less than half what TLC were earning. If expensive videos were a thing in the 60s, the Beatles may not have made any money in the early days. The Beatles would later negotiate a higher royalty rate and eventually started their own label, Apple Records, to ensure they'd get to keep the majority of the profits. TLC also managed to renegotiate their deal, but not before they had to sue the label LaFace Records and parent companies BMG and Arista. The new deal gave them an 18% royalty rate, increasing their share to $1.44 per copy. It also dissolved the management deal the group had with Pebbles, with them paying her a $2 million settlement. As she owned the rights to the group's name, they would also have to pay for that. Reports state the price for the name was $1 million for each letter. With new management and an improved contract in place, the follow-up album Fan Mail would have definitely not left them broke. The album sold over 10 million copies worldwide, and the group would go on to sell over 65 million records across all releases. Now times that by $1.44. So what do you think about TLC selling 10 million copies and still being broke? Let me know in the comments and be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications for all the latest videos from Traxploitation.